Hi everybody! So today's video is going to be just a simple makeup video on what my day-to-day look is. So it's going to be basically just face makeup. It's not going to be the extensive eye looks just yet. Probably in the future maybe I'll have the courage to actually do one of those. I used to do them before, but not really do them before as far as a video. I would do more of a picture type of tutorial where I would apply the makeup and then take pictures and then do like a video collage. So maybe in the future I will do an actual live or stream or do something like that where it's me putting it on and you can actually see me putting it on. In no way am I saying that I am a professional. I just love makeup, so why not? So, okay, let's see. To start off, I usually use a priming mist. I have a few different ones that I like to use, but the one that I usually go to right now is just a simple one that I bought from Marshall, or actually from TJ Maxx. And it is from Olivia Care, and it's just some like coconut rose water. So I just spray that on my face, let it refresh my face a little bit. Then I go in with my moisturizer, which is my go-to moisturizer all the time, and it is the Elizabeth Arden Visible Difference moisturizer. And I always change moisturizers, but I always find myself going to this one most of the time. And it's just because I like the way that my face feels afterwards. So you're just going to put it on your face evenly and let it sit into your pores. And if you want, which I usually do, I grab a little fan and I kind of like help it not be so, you know, I don't want to say wet, but you know, let it sit in before I apply any type of foundation. For the primer, I've been using the new e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. And I really like it. I used to use the Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser, but I saw this one and I've seen some videos on YouTube and I wanted to try it. So, I mean, I've been using it for a while, so I guess you can say that I really, really like it. It does give my face, I guess, a good canvas for the face products. So, you know, I put it wherever I have a lot of big pores. And it does tend to look diffused as far as, like, you know, I don't know what I'm trying to say. I guess, you know, making it more evenly, smoother so that the foundation can get on evenly and doesn't look like it's collecting in your pores. So I really like it, and the texture is very nice. It's I don't know what chemicals it has. I don't know if it's silicone based or anything like that. I just know it feels really, really nice. It's very nice and smooth. Okay, so got moisturizer, primer, and then the next thing that I wear, or not wear, but apply, is my actual foundation. And I've been using for quite some time the Laura Geller Quench and Tint. It is a hydrating foundation. And the color that I use is light, because as you can see, I am pale as can be. So I just apply it onto my hand, and then I grab a Beauty Blender. I just kind of dab it into the makeup. Get a good amount on the bottom portion of the beauty blender, and then I just start tapping it on. Tap, tap, tap. I try to do my cheeks first, then my chin area. And what I tend to do is I do one side first before I do the other side. I just feel that application wise, it distributes evenly. And it seems to work for me. So then up to the forehead. Just because I am not doing eye makeup, I do put some foundation on my eye and I set it later because I don't want to have uneven tones on my face. If I was going to put some eye makeup on, as far as like eyeshadows and liners and all that, I wouldn't put any foundation. I would obviously put a eyeshadow primer or concealer to be the base. But as of right now, I'm just doing the foundation because, like I said, I'm doing a very simple look. This is what I usually do when I'm going to work. If I'm in a bind and just need a quick, you know, face, that's what I do. All right, so again, I took the remaining product that was on my hand and I started tapping it on the other side of my face. Up to the forehead, making sure you're putting it as close as you can to your hairline, just because you don't want to have the outline of makeup where you can see your actual tone versus the foundation color. And then if you have anything left on your hand, I usually just try to grab whatever I have, plus use whatever is left on the beauty blender, and I put it on my neck. So I try drawing down from what I have on my face already, so there's an even blend. Excuse me. And I drag it down my neck, behind my ears, so that everything looks uniform and my neck is not a different shade than my face. Okay, so that's pretty much it as far as the foundation. Make sure you get your ears too. And then time for concealer. This foundation is not a full coverage foundation. I think you can build up to it, but it is not a one application full coverage foundation. Just so you know. Okay, so as far as the concealer, I have been using the... it's Maybelline, the Instant Age Rewind Corrector Eraser. So this one right here, where it has the little sponge, not sponge, but it has like, I don't know, it's a weird little applicator. And this is also in Warm Light, number 115. So you kind of just turn it and the product comes out into this little sponge. And what I do is that I put it under my eyes in triangle shapes on both sides. And then I also put it on the bridge of my nose, up to my forehead for a little bit, on my Cupid's bow, and a little bit on my chin. Grab the beauty blender again. Now I'm gonna be using the side of the beauty blender and just blending that out. Okay, so I got the nose done. Now I'm going to under my eye, and you're just going to tap, 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 tap until you feel that it's been blended as best as you want. If you feel that there's too much, you can always turn the sponge around and blend it more with the foundation using the remaining amount of product that you have on the sponge. Okay. So, after I have put on my foundation and my concealer, I'm gonna go in with a setting powder, but it's a pressed setting powder, and this one's from Maybelline Fit Me, number 120 in Classic Ivory. This one specifically is matte and poreless. And so I mean, it works for me. Not a lot of people like pressed powders, but I use this one to kind of set my foundation and concealer. And then after I've put like blush and if I do some type of bronzer, I'll use a setting powder that's loose just to kind of distinguish it. But for right now, I've used this pressed and it works for me. So you're just gonna dab I got a flat chiseled brush, and I want to use that for under my eye to kind of just set, and then continue to kind of press it into your cheeks. Also do your forehead. I tend to do this just because I have an oily T-zone, so I need to set my face and do it in the beginning just so that the makeup is not smearing or melting off my face. So make sure you got your chin, your nose. I do my eyes again because I'm not gonna put any type of eye makeup. And then to finish it off again with your chin, so not your chin, your neck, so it can go and blend all together with your face. And that's it. Okay. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put on some blush. And the blush that I use that I absolutely love is the Hot Mama blush from The Balm. And this one is a very close dupe to NARS Orgasm. So it's kind of like a peachy pink with some shimmers. So grab a blush brush, dab it into your blush, and then you want to apply it on your cheekbones. So some people like to just do some color, others like to have a lot of color. I'm kind of like an in-betweeny. Is that a word? I don't think it's a word, but yeah. And it might seem like it's a lot right now, but then again, when I go back with the loose powder, it's gonna diffuse it and it'll blend out very nicely. So. It's a little cheeky. Little red. All right. Now I'm going to go with. I just started using like bronzers because I just felt I was too white and I could never get it right. But I bought this bronzer from Too Faced called Natural Lust Bronzer, and it's a satin dual tone bronzer. So I really like it because it's very subtle, and it actually works for me. So this is what it looks like on the inside. I just take a fluffy brush, kind of dab it on, make sure I take off any of the excess, and then I kind of just like dab it on my forehead to give me a little bit of the glow that will make me look, I don't know, I guess it'll look better. Why do people bronze themselves anyway? So that they have like a natural glow? Did J.Lo start that or did Kim Kardashian? I don't know. So I do that. This brush is a little bit too big for my cheek area, so then I end up grabbing a side angle brush and just dabbing it a little bit, and then going into the cheekbone. If you don't know where it is, you can always squeeze your lips like that. I know I've seen people do the bronzer before they do the blush. I mean, I don't think there's a right or wrong way to do it. It's your preference. So, yeah. And then if you want to put it on your neck, you can kind of like chisel your jawline if you have no neck. And then, what do I do next? Next, I grab the setting powder, the loose one, and I use the Airspun Loose Face Powder. Who doesn't? I did buy a new one at Marshall. Was it Marshall? TJ Maxx. And this is from Absolute New York. And it's just an HD Flawless setting powder. Have not used that one yet. So I grab just whatever's on the lid, and then I grab a brush that came with a Tokidoki from Smashbox item a long time ago. I just never really used it, but I like the way that it's formed because it's dense, but it's pretty kind of like long shaped. And I just grab it and grab a good chunk, not a good chunk, but a good amount. And just try to, I guess, contour or like bake that area where the bronzer ends. Excuse me. And then I take another fluffy brush. This is the Sedona Lace FB03. And then I'll just go into the setting powder, dip my brush in, tap off the excess, and then I'm going to try to just diffuse the blush and the bronzer so that doesn't look too dramatic. And the same thing, kind of just like, you know, making sure everything is blended properly. I love this powder just because it gives a good feeling, satin fit feeling at the end to my face. Making sure that I blend the bronzer so I have a little bit, not a lot. That's pretty much it. If you feel that you still have to blend out your blush, just go ahead and blend it with the brush. So, pretty much it. Okay. It's gonna be a long video, apparently. Okay, so the next thing that I do is I do highlighter. And I take another angled brush, fluff brush. This one's, I don't even know from where, but it works. So the highlighters that I use are from the Balm, and this one is called Cindy Luminizer. And this one's just a matte, I mean not a matte, it looks like a very soft satin pink. So I've used it quite a lot. And for this one, I just use this as the color for my eyes. Very subtle, but it gives my eyes some type of life. Very simple. Just so that there's some color. Nothing drastic. And that's it for this one. Then I use the Mary Luminizer, which is this one. And this one is the Balm. Even though it's from the Balm, but it's a very nice champagne color highlighter. So grab it, put it on the top portion of your cheekbone, diffuse it into the blush if you can. Pretty. Do the same thing for the other side. And then I go on the bridge of my nose, on Cupid's bow, here, here. And that's pretty much it. Let's see what else. Oh, I did forget to do the contour of my nose. I don't do it all the time, but since I bought this one, I started doing it more often. So I just take a brush, like a big eyeshadow fluff brush, dip it in the brown section, and then you go like on the side of your nose and then kind of bring it down. Same thing with this side. Feel that you put too much, just blend it down, blend it down. Okay, so I think that's pretty much it as far as like powdery products. The next thing I do is my eyebrows, and I don't really need to do a lot because I probably should get them like plucked and cleaned up, but I don't really have to draw them because they're pretty, I would say they're there. So all I do is use the Maybelline Brow Fast Sculpt, and it is just kind of like a colored gel to help set your eyebrows. So just grab some and start putting it on your eyebrows. You know, everybody has like those little gaps in their eyebrows, so it's good to kind of fill in. But all you gotta do is I was hearing something, but just comb your hairs so that you can tame them down. And that's pretty much it. That's all I do. I don't really use a pencil. I don't use the powder. I mean, I could, I just don't. Some on my forehead. Once you are done with this, you can always take a Q-tip and clean up anything. I know some people do their eyebrows before they do their face makeup and use concealer to clean it up, but that's too much work. Eyebrows are not my priority. Okay, there you go. Next, what do I do next? Next, I take just a regular chapstick, put it on my lips. Grab a Q-tip. And this is just to take off the extra foundation that, you know, is on your lips. I'm hearing some crazy noise from my window. Sorry about that. Yeah, just taking off the extra makeup from your lip. That's it. Easy peasy. Okay. Let's see. Next, I do my, I think the only thing left would be my mascara. Unless I do liner, and I don't even know if I should do a liner. I could do a liner. All right, let's do a liner real quick. So I bought these eyeliners from Poudre. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, or if you can see that, but this is a blue eyeliner. Blue. Okay, so then just line your eyes and creating a wing. I usually don't do eyeliner just because my eyes are really sensitive and tend to water. I don't know if that's the proper term, but they get watery and then the eyeliners kind of smear. So I just don't do it as often as I would like. Okay, so I started from the middle, creating like little dashes. Then at the end, I kind of winged it outward to how far I like it. And then, let's see. Do you ever get a liner that you just doesn't work for you? All right, there we go. Not that it doesn't work for you, but the line is just not straight. See, now my eye is like kind of like watering right there, and then it's smearing. So I haven't done the inner portion of my eye because I'm feeling it already kind of like being sensitive. So I'm gonna wait to the end so that I can like focus on it. So I'm just gonna do this side. So I'm just creating like small dashes and then connecting them. Again, I'm not gonna do the inner portion of it. All right, let's swing it out. And then bring it in. That works. Go back in, make sure that your liner is close to your the edge of your eye and it doesn't have like any gaps, because then it's gonna look all weird. Okay, so now I'm gonna finish the inner portion. There we go. That side is fine. Sorry, I can't tell. I can't see the inner portion of the sign. Are you good? Alrighty. So, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna take another Q-tip because I don't want to. I don't know, can you see how it kind of transferred over here? I mean, that'll be fine, because when I put the mascara, it'll blend out. Okay. So now that I have the liner, the next thing is Mad Lash Black Mascara from The Balm as well. One of my favorite mascaras. Love the brushed brushes, it's curved, but just slightly curved. And this one is a lengthening mascara. I myself have very curvy lashes, so I don't need the curl. I feel like I don't need the volumizing one either. So I tend to buy mascaras that give me length, just because I have very short lashes. But once I use the lengthening one, it does look like I'm wearing falsies for some reason, even though I don't. I've never worn, well, not that I'm not going to say I never wore falsies, I just don't like them because they're so heavy on my eye. And I don't know, I feel like they make my eyes look smaller, and I already have small eyes. So I tend to use the mascara on the outside of my lash to apply it, and then I go to the backside and I pull it with the wand so that I'm coating both sides of the lash hair. And I make sure to go from the inner corner of my eye to the outer corner of my eye. Wiggle it side to side. Make sure you got good coverage. If you see that it's bulking up on one side, you can just try to, like, you know, make sure that it's evenly distributed. Okay. A couple coats and that's fine. Can you tell the difference between this side and this side? Can you? I don't even know. Can you? Probably not. Okay. Now I'm gonna do the second eye. Oh, I gotta also have to do the bottom part. It's probably the thing that, I guess, takes the longest. Just because, first of all, you gotta be careful that you are not, you know, smearing it on your actual eyelid. You also don't want to poke your eye, because that's happened a few times. The wand touched my bottom lash. Now I get why people do their lashes off camera and come back once they're done, because they take forever to do and you're usually not talking, so who wants to watch a person just putting on mascara when they're not talking, right? So let's see, are we almost done? Alright, let's get this video done, just because it's already past 30 minutes. That's a way too long video. Okay, good? I think so. Alright, so now I'm just gonna do the bottom lash, kind of rub across the bottom lash. I'm not perfect at it. I mean, not, it doesn't have to be perfect, that's what I was trying to say. And then you're gonna clean it up with a Q-tip, so don't worry. I really enjoy the wands that are like small mascara wands specifically for your lash line. Just haven't bought any recently. Okay. So once this is done, then all I need is my lipstick, but I'm debating whether I do it or not, just because if I'm going out, I am not going to be wearing lipstick because I have to wear my mask, right? So who wears a mask or who wears lipstick with masks? Okay, so I am kind of cleaning up below my eye and smearing the mascara just a little bit. And that's pretty much it as far as face makeup. Like I said, it's very simple. Sometimes I don't even have time to do the eyeliner and I just do the mascara, and that's enough. I feel that's enough. So there you go. Okay. Before I do my lipstick, I am going to put on some setting spray. I am using Smashbox Photo Finish Setting Spray, which is this one. Sorry. Close your eyes. It smells good. Again, I try to use my little fan so that it dries. I got this fan from Spain from like 10 years ago. Love it. Okay, then it is, from here I would do a lipstick, but I don't think I'm going to, just because I'm going out and I don't want to wear a mask or a lipstick if I'm gonna have to wear a mask. But if I were to choose one, I would probably choose a red lipstick, a liquid lipstick, and this is Morphe in, I think it's called Morphe. Yeah, this one specifically is called Morphe, from Morphe. Love it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So very simple, easy. I think it took longer because of the eyeliner, but this is my day-to-day face makeup application. Hope you liked it. If you have any questions or any comments or ideas for future videos, just let me know. If I said the word too many times because it's out of bad habit, then I apologize, but you know, it is what it is. All right, so everybody have a good weekend. Bye.